In this video, I am going to show you how to use the automatic setup feature in Shadow Keylogger. Automatic setup allows you to run the keylogger without having to manually configure the settings or type a password. This is useful if you are deploying the keylogger from a memory stick, or want it to run automatically every time the computer starts. To begin, I will show you what happens normally when Shadow Keylogger is opened. When I open the program, the usual window appears with empty text fields which I can fill with a password. And normally to start recording, I would have to click the record button here. Now, I am going to show you the automatic setup method. In Notepad, I have prepared a standard configuration file. As you can see from the first line, it is written in XML, which is a language that Shadow Keylogger understands. You will need to copy this template into Notepad to begin. You will find this template in the description below the video. In the lines below, there are tags that may look familiar to you, such as password, whether to start recording immediately, and the access mode. In order that Shadow Keylogger can find this configuration file, we need to save it in the same folder as the program. That's this folder over here on the desktop. Looks like I'm already there. Next, we need to save this file as config.xml. And in the drop-down menu below, select All Files. Then click Save. Now your configuration file is in the right place. Let's start changing our configuration a little. Remember, you can get this template from the description below the video. Let's start by choosing a password, which I will write between the two password tags. The next tag is asking whether I want to run the keylogger as soon as I open the program. It is currently set to 0, which means no. I will change it to 1. Because I do want it to run immediately. In the line below, there is a tag asking how I want to access the results at the end of the session. There are only two settings for this. Either manual or automatic. I will keep it as automatic. Next, the tag asking whether I want to include timestamps in my recorded data is set to yes. I will leave it like this. I want to have timestamps. This next tag determines whether Shadow Keylogger should save a backup of the keystrokes to the computer. I do not want this, so I will leave it as 0. This screenshots tag will determine whether screenshots are recorded or not. I do not want them for this session. Now that I have finished configuring my settings, I will save my changes and close Notepad. Now all I need to do is run Shadow Keylogger, and it will read my file automatically and just start recording. Just as we would expect, if I start typing, all my keystrokes are recorded by Shadow Keylogger, which has begun automatically. And as usual, if I enter the password that I created earlier in my configuration file, which was password 123, the results window appears with all of my recorded data. I hope you have found this video helpful. For more information, see the description below.